It will be joyful shouts and clapping of praise and worship today as Christians from different walks of life celebrate Legende Matters at Namgongo. Matters Day celebrations are held annually on June 3rd in commemoration of the 22 Catholic and 23 Anglican martyrs that were killed on the orders of Mwanga II, the Kabaka of Buganda. This year marks 138 since the martyrs were killed between 1885 and 1887. Over the weekend, different groups of pilgrims arrived at Namgongo Martyrs Shrine with the intentions they present to God through the saints. Security at the sites was also tightened to ensure the safety of all worshippers. All pilgrims were thoroughly checked to ascertain whether they were not carrying any explosives or other weapons. The security officers also conducted body searches on every Christian and their bags. At the Anglican site, the six dioceses under the Rwenzori cluster paced towards final preparations to successfully animate the celebrations. Nebbi Catholic Diocese will animate the celebrations at the Catholic site this year. Of Justice and Constitutional Affairs Norbert Mao and his fiancée Beatrice Nambi tied a knot at St. Joseph Cathedral in Gulu City. The couple were wedded on Saturday at the ceremony presided over by the Archbishop John Baptist Odam of Gulu Archdiocese.
I, Norbert Mao, do take thee, Beatrice Nambi, be my lawful wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part.
The Master Yewa and his wife Anita were best man and matron. The Tayewas handled the same role when Mao visited Beatrice's family in Wakiso.
Do you take me, Norbert Mao, to be my lawful wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, until death do us part.
A judiciary team was commanded by the Chief Justice Alphonse Owinyidolo and the Deputy Chief Justice Richard Butera. Several ministers, including the Chief Whip, Dennis Hampson Obua, and the Deputy Attorney General Jackson Karugaba Kafuzi, were among the guests at the cathedral. Several senior politicians of the Democratic Party also attended the ceremonies at the cathedral. South Africa's ruling ANC yesterday said it will enter talks with other parties to form a new government after losing its three-decade-old absolute majority in a watershed election. With 99.91% of the votes from Wednesday's election counted, President Cyril Ramaphosa's African National Congress had only 40.2%, a catastrophic slump of the 57.5% it won in 2019.
The ANC has accepted the result. And as the ANC, what is foremost now in our mind are two things. One is the fact that there was a clear protest.
The party must negotiate a coalition government or at least persuade others to back Ramaphosa's re-election in parliament to allow him to form a minority administration.
We're eating piece by piece, and then Zuma went to take the piece we're going to. But we don't complain. We want to humble the ANC. The ANC is very humble. We want to work with the ANC. If there's any party that we can work with and work properly, it's the ANC. Because ANC, when compromised, is not arrogant.
This marks a historic turning point for South Africa, as the party has enjoyed an absolute majority since 1994, when Liberation hero Nelson Mandela led the nation out of white minority rule and into democracy.